Power management company Eaton celebrating its 100-year anniversary, that of being listed here at the NYSE. We're going to talk energy rates and much more ahead of Fed Powell testifying before Senate Banking on Capitol Hill. And to do that, exclusively here on set at Post 9, is Eaton's chairman and CEO, Craig Arnold. Congrats. 100 years is impressive. Big deal.
Thank you. It's certainly a momentous occasion for our company to be around for 100 years, to be one of only 32 companies listed that long. And certainly it's an important milestone for our company. And it's a pleasure to be here today and celebrated here on the New York Stock Exchange.
I did wonder how many. Thank you for the answer, 32. All right, let's get to the current age here. You've got an Infrastructure Act. You have an Inflation Reduction Act. You would seem to be poised to benefit from both, particularly, as you said on your recent earnings call, $88 billion that's set aside for power grid updates and EV charging networks and incentives. How big an opportunity is that for your company, and over what time period do you see that playing out?
Yeah, I mean, the great thing about our company is we really are positioned to take advantage of what I would say are some of the most significant secular growth trends that I think we'll see in our lifetime. Energy transition, digitalization of the economy, electrification, all big secular trends that will benefit the company. And to your point, a lot of government stimulus spending on top of that, that will further accelerate our growth. And so we haven't yet seen the real impact of the stimulus spending. We think it's still to come, but we think it'll play out probably over the next, 3 to 5 years or so.
3 to 5 years is what you see. You know, when you talk about electrifying the economy as well, which obviously we all know about, but digitization also, explain here, because again, something you discussed during your recent conference call, exactly why Eaton's well-positioned and how that works.
Yeah, great. Let's think about it. The world today continues to generate, process, and store increasing amounts of information. We're all more connected than ever. One of the big growth segments for Eaton is a data center market. So it's one of our biggest end markets, and we serve the data center market. In addition to that, everything that we make today is becoming more intelligent. All the legacy devices that we've made, they all have microprocessors. They're all now connected and they're streaming data. That gives us the ability to sell higher value add in the components that we sell. At the same time, we have an opportunity to monetize the information and the insights that's coming off of these devices. And so through either selling data as a service or selling software.
You sell data as a service right now?
Absolutely. We're in the early stages, but a really exciting opportunity for us to really think about how do you create insights from the information that's coming off of the millions of devices that we actually have out in the marketplace.
How sensitive are your end markets right now to exactly the cadence of the economy at this point? What are you seeing and hearing back from customers?
You know, our end markets, I would say, are quite strong right now. And despite all the discussion about a potentially some sort of a recession this year, we think some 85% of our end markets see quite significant growth this year. You know, I think if you think about the trends that are going on, in addition to these secular growth trends, there is this big reindustrialization that's taking place today inside of the U.S., and we are a big benefactor of that. Every time you think about a new semiconductor plant, a new EV plant, a new battery plant, the numbers are just staggering today in terms of the amount of investment that's going into U.S. manufacturing, into U.S. market in general, and that's a real big benefit for us.
Do you worry about the grid? How do you answer concerns about the long-term load on the grid? Even those at the household level who are thinking, well, should I get an EV? Can I count on my charger in 5 or 10 years?
Yeah, I'd say we are helping utilities solve some of the big challenges today with respect to the aging grid that we have. And there does need to be quite a significant amount of investment that goes into modernizing the grid, building more resiliency in the grid. The great thing for Eaton is we provide all of the components, the hardware, the software, the services that the utilities need to upgrade the grid to get ready for what's coming at them. And it is significant if you think about electrifying the economy, not just cars, but more electric cooking and more electric water heaters. Everything in every aspect of the economy is becoming electrified, and that's going to continue to create challenges for the grid, and we are there to provide answers and solutions for our customers.
But do you see us as being behind the eight ball or approaching anything near crisis down the road?
No, I don't think we are approaching a crisis. I think there is work that needs to be done. I think there are investments that are being made today by the utilities. There are investments that are being made today by various actors in this value chain. But I do think we have to approach it with a sense of urgency.
Back to the economy, just because you do have an interesting sort of perspective on it. You did say on the call that you were feeling a little bit better about 23 than you had been even as much as a little as a month ago. Why?
Hey, if you think about, you know, today, the end markets that we serve, and one of the things that we pay attention to is the, let's call it the non-residential construction contracts. So macro data in terms of how much investment is going into infrastructure in the country. And those numbers were quite large at the end of the year, up some 50% for the year. And so we continue to see very strong demand in our orders. We see very strong demand in our negotiation pipeline that precedes order. And so our markets continue to be quite strong despite what you're seeing today in some of the macro data more around consumer products.
And that picked up a bit to encourage you a bit more?
Absolutely. We ended the year in a much stronger note than we anticipated. And we were already anticipating a good year for 2023.
All right. Well, a good year and your 100th to be listed here at the NYSE. Appreciate your taking time. Thank you.
Pleasure. Great to be here with you today.